道之学上可溯于炎黄，自老庄始成为一门独立的学问。与更加积极主动地参与社会生活的儒学不同，道学先天上就具有隐士逍遥的性质。被奉为道学祖师的老子和庄子，一位洞穿世事无常而选择了隐于无名，另一则认为天地一切都是拘系精神自由的枷锁而选择了无我逍遥。与此两者相比，儒家的先祖孔子一生都被社会政治所拖累，虽然营营终日，却仍逃脱不了死之虚无。因此，在中国几千年的历史中，一直有一群渴望着无所拘系的自由的人们，他们或谈玄，或炼丹，或修道法，或采真药，不论从形体还是从精神上，他们都不想在庸庸红尘中碌碌一生。正是因为他们敢于跳出世俗的眼光而去修正内心中的真我，因此世人便给予了他们一个特殊的名字，修真者，亦曰修道者，简而谓之道士。
The study of Tao can be traced back to Yan and Huang, and it has become an independent study since Lao and Zhuang. Unlike Confucianism, which is more actively involved in social life, Taoism is inherently reclusive. Liuzi and Huangzi, who are regarded as the patriarchs of Taoism, one pierced through the impermanence of the world and chose to remain anonymous, while the other believed that everything in the world was bound by the shackles of spiritual freedom and chose to live without self. Compared with the two, Confucius, the ancestor of Confucianism, was dragged down by society and politics all his life. Although he worked all day, he still could not escape the nothingness of death. Therefore, in China's thousands of years of history, there has always been a group of people who yearn for unfettered freedom.